bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. How are you doing? And how is everything? It has been a while I came live to do broadcast on the teachings on the prophetic. And a lot of people have been reaching me demanding for more of the teachings. It's because of my busy schedules. That's why I've not been seeing me live often. So today I want to talk on growing in the prophetic. All right, I want to talk on growing in the prophetic, and so we are going to look on some stuff relating to this subject I am talking about today. Let's pray. Father, we give you praise, we give you glory, we thank you for your faithfulness, for your kindness, for your love and your grace. There is none like you, there is none to be compared with you. You are great, you are big, you are strong. Lord, you are mighty, be thou exalted in the name of Jesus. Father, we are here because of your voice. We are here because of your ability to see into the supernatural. Lord, I pray for everyone that is listening to the sound of my voice, that is watching right now, that your anointing will come upon them in the mighty name of Jesus. I ask that your grace will be deposited in your children. Let there be expansion of your promise. Let there be pouring and outpour of your spirit upon all flesh. And let sons and daughters prophesy in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, as we go on in this teaching, we ask, oh God, that you will speak to us in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. So the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. So, like I said, today I'm going to be talking about growing in the prophetic. It is one thing to receive the gift. It is another thing to grow in the gift. All right, I think growing in the prophetic part two, because we have talked about the part one before. You heard what Paul the apostle said. He said to Timothy, he said, grow up the gift that have been imparted into you by the laying on of hands. And if you have been following the teachings very well, you must have watched the teaching on the labile and inner spirit. You know, I talked about the labor and the inner spirit. So Timothy was more like a folk in the inner, having the inner kind of spirit. And people that are in that dimension, after impartation, it takes further moves for you to begin to operate in that dimension you have been imparted with. So he was telling Timothy, stir up the gift of God which has been imparted into you by the laying on of hands. There are people that the ability begin to manifest immediately they receive impartation, while there are others where the ability requires some kind of exercise and principle for them to begin to operate in it. You look at the time where Paul the apostle, he was passing through a particular place and he saw some guys who got born again. They were happy that they were born again, but he asked them, have you received the Holy Ghost yet? And they said no. The moment he imparted them, the Bible said they received the Holy Ghost with the evidence of tongue and they prophesied. You see, those guys were men that were operating on the labile kind of spirit, the labile kind of spirit. And Timothy, who has been with Paul, was a very close son of Paul, have received the impartation, but he needed to stir it up. All right, he needed to stir it up, and that is one of the challenge that many are also facing today. You are saying, I've received impartation, but these things are not manifesting. There are things you do to stir up this gift. You have heard me in the part one of this teaching that one of the major ways of growing your prophetic gifting is by practice. All right, today I'm going to be talking on something a bit different from what we have learned before. All right, if you look at the book of Mark chapter 11, Mark 11 verse 24, the Bible was speaking in that place. Jesus Christ speaking said, he said, whatsoever ye desire, praying, believing that you have received them, you shall have them. Whatsoever ye desire, praying, believing that ye receive them, you shall have them. All right. So now, you that is watching me right now, the reason why you are watching this broadcast now is because this video right now is because you have a desire inside of you to prophesy. And there are times in your life where you have prayed. You have prayed to receive this gift. You believe that God can cause you to operate in this dimension to hear His voice. And yet, it seems like you are not still hearing His voice. Is it that the word of God is contradicting, or the word of God is lying? Or why have you not started operating in it? If you have desired it, you have prayed it, you believed it, but it didn't happen. Then I now discovered something, that when God speaks of belief, the God kind of belief is different from man kind of belief. All right, God kind of faith is different from man kind of faith. What we see to be belief is not close to the belief of God. What we see to be belief is unbelief in the eyes of God. You look at the book of Mark chapter 9 verse 24. Before the verse 24 of that chapter, Jesus Christ was asking a father, the father of a son who was highly possessed with evil spirit, and the spirit would be throwing the child down on the stones, on into fires and different. And Jesus Christ was, how long has this thing lasted? And the man said it. And Jesus Christ told, Jesus Christ asked the man, he said, man, do you believe? And the man said, yes. The man cried out in verse 24, Mark 9, verse 24. The man cried out and said, yes, Lord, I believe. Help my unbelief. That statement was made with deep mystery that even the man don't understand. It was made out of deep cry of mystery. I believe, help my unbelief. You just said you believe, and you are saying the Lord should help your unbelief. It the man thought it, to men it was natural for him to cry that way, but it was a cry of mystery. All right, the reason why, let me point to you the first thing. The reason why Jesus Christ looked at him, even to heal the son in the first place, was because the guy has touched the Lord in the spirit. So the guy at that point was operating from the frequency of the spirit, even unknowingly to him. He said, Lord, I believe, help my unbelief. I believe, help my unbelief. The reason why the Lord asked him if he believed was because the Lord was seeing unbelief. But the guy in his heart knows that he believed. Are you seeing what I'm saying? So the belief system of man is different from the belief system of God. What you are seeing to be belief is not even belief at all. What you are seeing to be faith is not faith at all. That is why people that says, I have faith, still go and pray for the sick and they still remain sick. They said that the faith is there. They went to pray for the dead remain dead. Why? To them, they had the faith, but in the eyes of God, there was no faith at all. So what I'm going to be talking about today, I told you how to grow in this gift. So what I'm going to be talking about today is how to attain the God kind of faith that makes you to grow in the gift you have received by impartation or by prayers anyways. Are you getting what I'm saying? So how to grow this gift you have received. So how do you attain the God kind of faith? How do you attain the God kind of faith? If you look at the Bible very well, the Bible said faith without action is dead. Faith without action is dead. God knows that you have faith until there is a provocation of action. God knows that you have faith until there is a proof of action. All right? A proof of action. The young man, the man Abraham thought he knew he had faith. He was a man of faith, highly, highly loaded with faith. He had strong belief, and he thought God knew about his faith. Not until God wanted to know if he really had faith and said, give me Isaac. It was only action that could justify that he really had faith. Are you seeing it? So sometimes when we say we have faith, God wants to see the operation of this faith. So how do you grow your prophetic gift as relating to God kind of faith? If you check the first place I read in Mark chapter 11 verse 24, it said, whatsoever ye desire Whatsoever ye desire, that's what the apostle said, desire that you may prophesy. Whatsoever ye desire, praying that you have them, you receive them, you shall have them. So, which means by now you are supposed to be operating in the prophetic. So, why is this not manifested? So now, God told Abraham, give me Isaac. It's a proof. If you look at the book of Luke, I think chapter 22 verse 19 or 19 verse 22, the Lord said to the disciple, he said, when I send you without purse, without shoes, without clothes, do ye lack anything? And the disciple replied and said, we lacked nothing. Are you seeing it? When the first time he called them to send them out on evangelism, those guys took shoes, they took money. They took a lot of money, they took a lot of shoes, a lot of clothes that will make them to be able to maintain their self and to stay healthy before they get back. He said, drop everything. They went without clothes. They went without shoes. They went without money. But when they came back, he asked them, they said, we lacked nothing. The reason why they didn't lack anything was because they were operating on the God kind of faith. Another way of growing your gift is moving from your comfort zone of kind of faith to the God kind of faith. There are people that said, I don't want to go and minister the word of God until this gift comes. But God is saying, this gift cannot come until I see your faith by ministering my word. Are you seeing it? So you need to engage in what is called evangelism. You must engage in the ministry of the word. Now, some persons grow their gift majorly by evangelism. I have a friend of mine who his ears got open while he was on evangelism. It was when he was preaching that immediately his ears opened and he started hearing clearly more than before. He has received impartation. It was not manifesting. It was during evangelism his eyes opened. He started hearing God. Are you seeing it? So evangelism is one of the platform of manifesting the God kind of faith. I believe in God. I believe in what he can do. If he send me, I will go. If he speak to me, I will do what he says. But what he has said in his word, have you done that? All right. Practice what has been written. Then what is not written will be revealed. All right. So that is one of the way of increasing the God kind of faith. You must embark on evangelism. Embarking on evangelism. And you need to embark on evangelism. The second way of manifesting the God kind of faith is praying tirelessly or without ceasing. You see, there are persons that pray for this gift. They don't have the opportunity to meet someone that can impart them. They prayed for this gift, but they don't have the patience of tarrying for long in the place of prayer. All right, you want to grow in this gift, you must be able to tarry in the place of prayer. You have received impartation, and you are the innate kind of spirit. You have received even the labor kind of spirit. I'm going to be talking something about them that requires them to have a lot of time in the place of prayer. All right, so you have received this thing. But you need to engage in prayer. You need to engage in fervent, extensive prayer. Prayer that is long enough. I want you to understand something, that praying links a man to the spirit world. And it is impossible. It is impossible for a man to be praying in the spirit for long and not receive any message from the spirit. It's impossible. Except you are praying in the spirit, but in the flesh. You are praying in the spirit, but your attention is in the flesh. Messages are coming, but you cannot realize this message. Are you seeing it? So now, one of the things that regular impartation does is to make it easier for you to receive message from that realm. But if you are not imparted, during prayer, you should be able to receive some prophetic messages. All right, so you must engage in long, extensive prayer. You must have a long, extensive prayer life. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I told you one time that the first time I had an experience of in the prophetic where my spirit left my flesh was when I was praying an extensive prayer. The first time I prayed the longest. It was compared to now, it's a little time, but it's the longest then. Are you seeing it? So I want you to understand, you need to engage in prayer. It's also an act of God kind of faith. If he believes, he will pray without ceasing, as I have said. If the young man believes, he will pray without ceasing, as I have said. If the young woman believes, he will pray without ceasing, as I have said. How come there are people with prayerless life and still want to manifest in the prophetic? You want to be attacked? You want to operate in the prophetic to see things that are natural eyes cannot see, and you don't have a prayer life? There are people that, because of their lack of prayer life, when they are launched into the spirit, it affects them. It can affect them mentally, because you can encounter a being that your spirit is not strong enough to handle. It becomes a very big issue. Are you seeing it? If you encounter a being that is strong enough for your spirit to handle, it becomes a problem. So you don't just want to enter into the spirit being half-baked. You need to engage the lifestyle of prayer. So the third thing, if you look at, the Bible said something. The Bible defined faith. It said faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So he said the substance, when the Bible mentioned faith as a substance of the things hoped for, a substance is something that is tangibly, visibly feelable, something that can be felt, something that can be touched. So he said faith is the substance of things that, he says faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. What is the evidence of the thing you have not seen that God can see? All right. For instance, you said you have faith. God is in the spirit realm, and you are in the physical realm. You are praying to receive. Let me use a car for instance. You are praying to receive a car from the spirit realm. And God is in the spirit realm, waiting to see your faith from the physical realm. You want to receive a substance, because car is an example of a substance from the spirit realm. And God is waiting to see an example of a substance from your realm to his realm. Are you seeing it? So faith is the substance of the things hoped for. What are you having as a substance that is standing as a faith for you? All right, you there are different kinds of substance. It may be substance in terms of sowing of cars, sowing of house, growing of seed of faith. That's why they call it seed of faith. The reason is because, now let me tell you something, the faith of man is incomplete until he is able to give what will pain him. The faith of man is incomplete until he is able to give what will touch him. The faith of man is incomplete until he or she is able to give that which has an impact in him. The faith of man is incomplete until he or she is able to give up what he or she values so much. So you see, when they were giving in the Bible and Jesus Christ looked at them, the disciples were not even asking who is the person that gave more. And Jesus Christ said to them, he said, this woman, this widow gave more because she gave out of her want. The reason why, said, so the woman in the eyes of God will receive more from God, not because she was a widow, but because she gave out of her value. But these guys were giving because they were super rich. They just took $100,000 and just gave. They just took something and just gave. Things that doesn't shake them. But a guy with faith, are you seeing it? A guy, a young man, a young lady, an old man or an old woman with a strong kind of faith will give out of his what value to provoke something upon him. To provoke something. Are you seeing it? So another way of attaining the God kind of faith is with your substance. With your substance. It makes faith very easy. Your substance makes faith very easy. Are you seeing it? Solomon had no faith of being able to become the wisest man in the world. He had no faith of being able to become the richest man that will ever live. But his substance was a faith that stood in the gap that even himself cannot stand in. Are you seeing? His substance could stand in that gap that even he himself could not stand in. And so it was released upon him. He received it via the platform of faith. You will do yourself good when you have faith. To attain the God kind of faith, it will require your effort, either by substance, literal evangelism is another way of growing your gift, prayer. I'm mentioning three now in this part two of this series. So you need to start following this up. You want to operate in these giftings. These are things you must put to practice. These are things you must put to practice. Then God will begin to operate with you. Then God will begin to flow through you. God is looking for a medium to pass through, and you can become that medium. Are you hearing me? The Lord will release grace upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you in the name of Jesus that the gifts you are of God will come upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. Those of you that have received the ability, received the gift of prophecy, and yet you are not operating in the dynamism of it, you want to accelerate in the gift, you want to become more accurate and clear in this gifting, I ask that as you will follow principle, the Lord will release it in greater dimension upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive fresh impartation now in the mighty name of Jesus. I release grace in the mighty name of Jesus. I release grace in the name of Jesus. List of prayer. There is a woman I'm seeing. You are going to be watching this broadcast. I saw you. I saw a child close to you, a very young child. There is an experience you used to have. And this experience, you usually see like beings walking into your rooms. These are angels walking into your rooms, but you cannot detect. Most times you are afraid and very scared to be able to even get the reason why they are coming. All right. When you watch this broadcast, I want you to reach me. I'm going to teach you on how to go about it. I'm going to try to explain a little to you. All right. The Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus. I release grace upon you watching right now, upon my sons, my daughters. I release grace upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare that your hunger to hear the voice of God will bring forth result in the name of Jesus. Father, I ask, let there be impartation of your giftings upon them. Let there be fresh release of oil upon your sons, your daughters, now in the mighty name of Jesus. Cause them to hear you, Lord. Cause them to see in the spirit. Let nothing be hidden from them in the mighty name of Jesus. Renes epenikus etibalahadis. There is a man, you are watching me, you are a prophet, you have a ministry, you have been operating a prophetic, but of late it seems you are not seeing again. All right, you have started struggling in the prophetic, it's not accurate again. I release grace for accuracy in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord is telling me you need a father, you need a mentor, somebody to mentor you. I release grace upon you in the name of Jesus. Father, I ask, let the eyes open to see clearly again in the mighty name of Jesus. I release grace upon them. Father, I release grace upon them. Father, let there be manifestation of your grace upon your sons and your daughters. Those watching me right now, I declare that the angel of my calling will begin to clear their eyes, every veil removed in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you in the name of Jesus. So I don't know when next I'm going to be coming live to teach, but as time goes on, when I'm chanced, I'm still going to be coming back to teach. There are a lot of things we are going to be talking on. And if you have questions, drop it on the comment section. Some of you sent questions to me on WhatsApp, but on some on email, but I don't think I may be able to remember them. So put it on the comment section here so that I can be able to, when I see the comment section, I can be able to relate to those questions in other teachings. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine upon you. In Jesus' mighty name. Shalom.